I wholeheartedly stand what I said before. Fast-moving rolling releases like Arch Linux are incredibly important for the FOSS world. And look, if you're using one like I am, you basically are a beta tester for the rest of the Linux world, often protecting these slow-moving distros from ever having to see certain bugs. Now, testing branches are incredibly important for those distros, but also for Arch Linux as well. Arch isn't just throwing Git packages at you with absolutely no expectation of usability, it's still trying to be a useful distro. It's just a useful distro that happens to be one of the first ones that sees a bunch of bugs. But sometimes, things don't get caught during testing and make their way into stable. Now, hopefully, it's some little usability thing like, oh, this button doesn't work correctly, oh, this thing is rendering weirdly. What you hope it's not is a lot of people completely unable to use their system. And today, we have one such case like that. Now, if you follow my social media or you see my YouTube community post, you may have already seen me talk about this, but I wanted to save the actual, you know, deep explanation for the video itself. So, sometime last week, I started seeing posts like this one. Bottles doesn't launch.exe after updating the kernel 6.13.1-arch1-1. But at the same time, I was seeing posts like this one here. Broadcom WLDKMS is not working on 6.13.1. Now, in retrospect, these are completely unrelated issues. But it seemed like there were a lot of problems with that release, so it was kind of unclear at the start what was actually going on. The one that I cared about, though, was the first one. Not because of bottles, but because of the other things that were also affected. There was also a report over on the Arch Linux forum. Bug, bad page state in process compositor after update to 6.13.1. Computer was unusable after a while of running, could not close my web browser, the currently open terminal emulator could not launch most new processes, etc. BTOP, for example, could launch, but it would show nothing inside it, almost as if proc wasn't accessible anymore. And this is what they saw in their journal CTL. Bug, bad page state in process compositor, and a bunch of other stuff here. In the replies, we didn't have it say compositor, but we did have bug, bad page state in process, fuse, main loop, and a bunch of other users all noticing problems. Now, because 6.13.1 was a very problematic release, there were people that had different issues like this one here that just happened to also be on the same version, but most of these people were experiencing the exact same problem. Some sort of bad page state weirdness that didn't really make any sense. One person thought, oh, well, are we all on ButterFS? Turns out a lot of them were, but no, some people have the issue and on a completely different file system, so clearly that's not what it was. However, people were able to consistently replicate the problem using applications like Bottles. But Bottles was not the only thing. I was talking to my friend about this, and she was not able to open up her web browser. Every time she did, it just was not working. What do these have in common? Both of these were installed as a Flatpak. And eventually, this made its way into the Arch Linux GitLab, which is always a bit of a challenge because they don't actually have open signups. You have to reach out to support and then they make an account for you. It's a big mess. Anyway, they did quite a bit more digging on the issue. Somehow when using Flatpak, interacting with certain files in some ways can cause these crashes. I was able to reproduce this issue with the Flatpak packages of multiple apps and can also confirm that this issue does not happen when installing another non-Flatpak version of the package. The issue is always reproducible and leads to a full system crash, sometimes after a while, sometimes immediately. This issue is not reproducible with the Linux kernel 6.12.12, that is the LTS kernel, but both with 6.13 and 6.13.1 on multiple devices. I guess expected behavior would be to not crash, which, you know what? I think everybody can agree with. So the steps to reproduce, very simple. Use a Flatpak package, for example, Arnode. In that case, import a PDF file, and then the kernel dies. Noticing what it throws, bug, bad page state in process, the same thing we were seeing over here from a bunch of different users. Now, this didn't just get reported to Arch, it was also sent to the Flatpak team, who basically said, this is not our problem. We couldn't make this happen if we tried. This is a kernel issue. Go to your distro, go to the kernel, bug them about it. With the kernel functioning correctly, user space software should not be able to do this no matter what they try to do. It's definitely a kernel bug. It is a bug in FUSE, file system in user space. This is something that you've probably interacted with a lot of times, but may not have ever really thought about. Basically, it's a set of kernel APIs that allow you to run a file system in user space, but why would you want to do that? Well, let's say you have a file system that is not supported in the kernel. For example, NTFS. Let's say you want to do something like mount an Android phone, or mount an Apple device, or mount a cloud drive, or a bunch of other things. Like, there's one here specifically for dealing with Google Drive, or using Git as a file system. These are things that you wouldn't be using as, like, your core file system, but there are edge cases where it makes sense to mount this as if it is a file system, or in the case of a network drive, treat it like a drive on your system. And to absolutely nobody's surprise, applications that operate in a sandbox also make use of file systems in user space. Whilst Flatpak is the most obvious way to deal with this problem and it has a very, very clear replication condition, because this is a problem with a kernel API used by a lot of different applications, it is entirely possible that if you didn't have any Flatpaks on your system, but you still heavily made use of FUSE, you would still run into this issue. So I've not seen any direct reports of that, but theoretically it should be possible. Now, as seems to always be the case when dealing with a bug like this, the very first comment doesn't happen on my system. I can't replicate it. Every time, every single time, even something where there is a super clear, super clean replication condition, there's always gonna be at least one works on my system. In this case, the reporter does mainly use the CatchOS kernel. However, the issue does still persist on the Arch kernel. And I guess they didn't read that part because they went through a package list, brought up the fact that CatchOS is there, even though that's specifically said that it happens on both of them, but, you know, bug reports. People go through every possible thing, even if something has already been mentioned. They even went out of their way to remove the CatchOS kernel, remove the CatchOS repos, make sure everything is just super clean Arch Linux, and the problem was still happening. And they even updated to 6.14-RC1, and the problem was still happening. However, next comment was from someone who could replicate the issue, and on their system, it wasn't an issue with the LTS kernel, 6.12.12, but it did happen with the stable kernel. So most likely, like the reporter said in their original report, it's kernels 6.13 or newer, and then another person was also able to replicate the issue. The other person who couldn't replicate it, still couldn't replicate it, and was still trying to work out how to replicate the problem. They seem to be just a weird outlier. Maybe, I don't know, they had the Flatpak being able to access their entire system, so it wasn't going through the portal or anything like that. Possibly that's what the issue was, but everybody else could replicate the issue except for this one person. So putting aside that one weird case that still can't be explained, now it is time for everyone's favorite thing, Git's bisection. We know when the problem didn't exist and when the problem did exist, but we don't know exactly which commit caused the issue, and Git bisection is how you do that. Now, normally the person doing the bisection just does everything themselves. In this case, though, they didn't exactly know which points to go with, so we have line by line each command that was run to do the bisection. If you're curious about how the process works, this, I think, is a really good explanation. And the bisection was successful. The bug was tracked down to 3EAB9D7B, authored on September 30th. FUSE convert read ahead to use folios. And this bug is very clearly present in the FUSE code. If this part isn't obvious enough, the only file changed is a FUSE file. Now, initially there were some thoughts that this had already been reported, that being in silent data corruption in FUSE in RC1, submitted by Kent Overstreet. Now, Kent is normal Kent stuff in this thread. That's not really that important though. The patch that was from this thread is already included in the kernel, so very clearly not that problem. Here is the actual report. Regression, bisected, crashed with bad page state for FUSE/Flatpak related applications since version 6.13. And all of this description here is stuff we've already read. So let's go... They included the entire log here, so there's a bit to scroll past. Jesus Christ. Wait, where is it? Still going? Oh, there it is. Jesus Christ. Surely there was a better way to deal with that. Now, there are a bunch of replies here from people working on FUSE trying to work out exactly what the problem is, how the problem happened. They know the commit that's causing the problem, but you don't submit code that is bad, right? So the code looks fine. People check the code. The developers think the code is good. So now you have to think, okay, well, the code's actually bad. Why is it bad? What's bad about it? Here is a reply from Vlastimil Bubka. This is the person who ends up writing the actual patch. I see that commit removes folio put from FUSE read pages end. Also, it now uses read ahead folio in FUSE read ahead, which does folio put. So that's suspicious to me. It might be storing pointers to pages to AP pages without pinning them with a ref count, but I don't understand the code enough to know what's the proper fix. A probably stupid fix would be to use underscore underscore read ahead folio instead and keep the folio put in FUSE read pages end. Followed by this reply from Yosef. Agreed. I'm also confused as to what the right thing is here. It appears the rules are if the folio is locked, nobody messes with it, so it's not correct to hold a reference on the folio while it's being read. I don't love this way of dealing with folios, but that seems to be the way it's always worked. I'm knee-deep in other things. If we want a quick fix, I think your suggestion is correct, Vlastimil. Resulting in this absolutely giant patch, 4 insertions, 2 deletions, and this is just adding a bracket so there can be more than one call in this block, so realistically, this isn't actually a real change, so it's more like one insertion here, one insertion here, and then removing that line. That's basically it. When you have a really complex issue, oftentimes the solution is really, really simple. And by all accounts, this fix the problem. Everyone who has tested it seems to be perfectly fine. I have gone and updated my system. I have absolutely no issue here, which is good. And that's the main reason I wasn't updating to it beforehand, because I use OBS as a Flatpak. I use a bunch of other Flatpaks. I kind of need my Flatpaks to work and my system to not be crashing. I also spoke to my friend who had the exact same issue as well, and their problem is gone as well. So it seems like if you were worried about this problem, if you saw my posts about this, if you were like, okay, I'll hold off on updating, now you're pretty much gonna be good. Go update your system, keep on doing your thing. One person makes a great point here. Let's see how it goes. Dunno how this escaped testing. Yeah, I have no idea either. I guess nobody was testing Flatpaks, because there are people that use testing on their system before it goes into stable, so I don't know, maybe that's something people should add into their testing suite. And here's just a fun little side note. I don't know why Arch Linux has a newsfeed. Random things, like a glibsy bug that caused a banner in Discord and audio didn't work, but text would still work, that deserves a post on the newsfeed. but not people's systems hard crashing from using random flatpaks. Priorities, I guess. I don't know. If you actually want to know what is happening on Arch Linux, don't even look at the newsfeed. Just go to the Arch Linux subreddit. If there's something on the newsfeed, it'll be posted there, but so will all of the other problems. So again, if you're holding off on updating, now you're good to do it. I don't know how this didn't get caught during testing, but you know what? At least it got caught before it made its way into a big distro. So again, thank Arch Linux for having people willing to beta test everything for you so your distro doesn't have to do as much work. But what do you think? Did you experience the problem? Were you someone who updated and didn't see anything? Or were you holding off until everything were dealt with? Or maybe you had no idea the problem was even happening and you're just finding out now. I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, silly bear pay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and I am your Arch Newsfeed.